Hello there, it's Sandy Alnock, and today we're starting the Advent series for 2021. Are we already at Advent? Oh my gosh. This year I'm doing bookmarks, all in colored pencil. And before I start, I thought I'd talk about the pencil nibs that I'm going to be using that you're going to see. This is a normal pencil tip, but I'm going to be using this AFMAT pencil sharpener that I bought earlier this year. I was curious. A lot of artists seem to use it. And you put the pencil in and crank the handle and it pulls the pencil in for you. And it looks like it's eating away at your pencil, but it's actually not. I did a test and it doesn't actually shorten the pencil point, the pigment at the end. It's just using all that crunchy noise to make that long point. It's shaving off all that wood. And inside there is a piece of sandpaper. My first one didn't come with it, so I had to write to them to ask for one because they left it out of mine. But you can rub the tip of it on there and then make your pencil point really sharp using that. I don't know that there's any great reason to have this sharpener over any others unless you just like the look of a long pencil point. I happen to find that it makes me hold my pencil back a little bit further on the pencil because my hand tends to just crowd the tip. And that tries to make me really careful about what I'm doing, and it just doesn't allow me to be free. So I prefer something that makes me have my hand back further. It's the way I paint. It's the way I use all of my supplies. I like to have that freedom of expression with my hand and my arm, and this helps with that. So just leave it out there for you to decide what you want for your pencil points. This also can weaken a soft pencil point. The polychromos have a very strong lead in them, just the way that they're made. Doesn't make it better or worse. Some softer pencils, like Prismacolors, do a great job because they're soft and the pencil comes off really easily from the tip of the pencil. So it's all personal preference as far as I'm concerned. I'm going to be using all layering with this because I also don't want to use super heavy pressure when I've got these long points. I don't find they break very much with the polychromos because they are very sturdy points. But in general, I really like layering colors because I can invent more colors in between all the colors that are there by just putting a little bit of an orangey yellow over top of a yellow. I can get beautiful gradients. I can get transitions between colors. I've got the color wheel up in the corner. That's really how I'm basing all of these videos during the Advent series. All the bookmarks will have some sort of relation to the color wheel. And I've started with warm colors around the central figure. And there is a second page to the PDF with no figure in it. So if you would like to create this and draw your own figures, make them look like whoever it is that you're going to make this for, if you want to draw a portrait of yourself walking, if your shape is going to be different than this, if you want to make it male, if you want to put a family in it, whatever you want. The idea is that when we are looking for hope, when we're striving forward to see hope in the future, it sometimes feels like it's off on the horizon. We can see Jesus out there. We know he's there and we're walking toward him, but we're still caught in the rest of it. So I wanted this to feel like a tunnel. So the outside, the top and the bottom, are going to get into cooler colors, which is deeper in the tunnel, and warmer colors as you get out into the light. So I'm just following the color wheel and creating these shapes. Now you can create this without using the download. The download that I have has very pale lines in it so that you don't end up with harsh lines in your drawing. But you can also just draw your own. Just get circles of different sizes and layer them over each other and move the circles left, right, up, down so that you don't end up with concentric circles, because otherwise that can be kind of dizzying. It can look like you're in a tube, and I wanted it to feel more like you're in a tunnel, and you'll see as this develops, it has that almost a stained glass feel. This one almost ended up in the stained glass class that I just launched, but it didn't. It ended up as a bookmark instead. I have sketchbooks full of ideas, and sometimes they end up here, sometimes they end up in classes and all that sort of thing. But nonetheless, I'm going to be moving myself from the yellows and the oranges and reds into the purplish types of reds. So a purple that has more of a red in it, and then purple that's more blue, and then it's going to get bluer on the outside edges as it develops. This video is already part of the Hunger for Hope class. If you signed up for that last year, you know that the Hunger for Hope class was a fundraiser we did. And the class is still there, and I'm still going to be adding to it each year. In that class, you get all of my Advent series videos together. So all of the Hope videos from the first week of Advent each year are in one place. And then you get all of the Love videos and all of the Joy videos and all the Peace videos. But the class is not just about getting all those easily in one place rather than scrolling through my YouTube channel to find them. It's about being the hands and feet of Jesus. We're used to being the hands of Jesus when we make our artwork, but sometimes we need to just be the feet of Jesus and go out and serve. And by fundraising to help the hungry, we can do that. Your $10 that you pay for the class goes 100% to charity to feed the hungry. 100%. I take no administrative fees. I just pass it all on at the end of the year. And I'm real excited to see if we can top last year's giving. Last year, we gave $680. And this year, I would like to increase that. If you signed up for the class last year, you've already got the class in your account, so you can just go in and look at the content. But if you would like to contribute to the cause and help us to fundraise more than $680, you could buy the class again. It's not going to hurt anything to just purchase it a second time. And your amount will be included in the total at the end of the year when we give our monies. So if you want to make your bookmarks ahead of time, sign up for the class. Link is in the doobly-doo. I am making sets of bookmarks, so I'm coloring like a mad person right now in order to try to get some of these done. I want to give some as sets, some as individuals, and you'll see at the end I bought some sleeves to put them in so that the colored pencil doesn't smear and smush. If you are also somebody who likes to make handmade gifts as much as I do, there's also a class that I launched a few years ago, and I thought I'd bring it up again since we're talking about making gifts, and this one is called Scripture Gifts, and it shows you how to make handmade books, very, very small books. These are not major books, but how to make handmade books with scriptural themes. There are downloads in there. There's some stuff you could use, supplies you already have at home. There's some that you can order some simple things from Amazon and get the supplies you need real easily to make some beautiful handmade gifts that also convey the word of the Lord to those who you are giving gifts to, whether it's family, friends, Bible study friends, Bible journaling friends, your pastor, Sunday school teachers, whatever. So I'll have links to that class as well in the doobly-doo. Now back to the artwork. I'm moving out to the edges now, and you can see I'm getting more into purples and blues and getting out there on the color wheel. And I opted to just stop at purples and blues. I'm going to use more types of purples and blues together instead of like switching on to get into the greens. There will be a little bit of a blue-green color in some of these, but I'm making the top part transition more slowly, so I get a lot more of the purple, and then it goes into the blues. The bottom goes a little quicker. You know, there's like a very little bit of purple, and then we go into the blues. And as I started getting further into those outer edges, I wanted them to get darker. So I started using a navy blue to just darken each one of those colors and to bring them together so that they were separate sections of color, but they blend really nicely together and they don't feel like they're all, you know, separate chunks of color. Because part of the reason that I loved the whole idea of this was that there would be soft transitions between one color and another, even though there were definitive color breaks, that this would all feel like one big amazing tunnel that you're walking through. And you can see how concentric circles wouldn't quite have this flavor of being almost cave-like, like this does. So I'm going to add a small shadow in a dark blue underneath of the figure. And then I'm going to put it onto a piece of cardstock. Now you can use whatever color cardstock you want. I decided for black for all of mine because I have a ton of black cardstock sitting around here. And cut it to fit. And you could blow these printouts up or shrink them down to whatever size you need them to, trim them down as desired, you could put several layers of cardstock underneath in different colors, all different kinds of options you have for finishing them off. And as I said, I ordered some bookmark sleeves. You could use a spray on these to keep the pencil from moving too much, but I haven't found any sprays that I like well enough that they would withstand the use that someone would get with a bookmark, because you're constantly moving and touching a bookmark, and a bookmark sleeve tends to protect it a little bit better. There's a lot of different styles that you can get on those, but this is the one that I chose. So the Hunger for Hope class is linked in the doobly-doo down below, as well as scripture gifts, so you can check those out, and the whole Bible journaling category, because there's other classes there too if you're interested in that. And I will see you again very soon. God bless you. Bye-bye.